In this video, I'll be showing you the workflow that I use for photogrammetry and game dev assets. I decided to use Meshroom version 2019 because for some reason the unwrap method LSCM and ABF just would not work. I could not get it to work. Lighting is very important for the outcome of the mesh, so I think overcast weather is perfect for photogrammetry. If it's not overcast, then just find a shady area or have a well-lit room. Also, make sure to have a camera or device that is sufficient for high-definition photos. Okay, before you start the process of taking photos, and as you're gradually taking photos around the object, start from top to bottom. Alright, now we can get started. So the first thing you're going to do, once you have all the photos that you've taken, just drag and drop right here. We're going to look at texturing first. And for mine, I'm going to set it to 4K texture size. I'm going to leave texture downscale to 1. And texture file type to PNG. And unwrap method to LSCM. And it should be good. And over to meshing. It's originally 50 million and 5 million input points and max points. I'm just going to reduce this to 1 or 10 million and 1 million for max points. 1 million for max points and 10 million for max input points. And save project to wherever folder you would like. I'm going to call this rock. And I'm going to start it. Once it starts, it'll be green means that it is finished, and orange means it's in progress. All right, it just got finished, and let's see it. To see it, just hide structure for motion. And here it is. Looks pretty good. And when you're ready to access the model and texture, just go down to the texturing node, right click, and here are all the contents. Okay, once you're in Blender, we're going to go over to File and import the mesh that we've exported from Meshroom. Just going to rotate it. Gonna go into edit mode to get rid of all these unnecessary vertices. Gonna go over to X-ray mode. And see to get the little details. And let's delete. And when you're happy with that, we're going to go over to File and Export and call this low. And keep Blender open. And let's hop over to Instant Meshes. We're going to open the mesh that we've exported from Blender. And Instant Meshes is going to allow us to retopologize the high poly version of the mesh. So let's reduce this number to something around 213, and you can keep it at quads, but I think I want to turn it to tries. Solve and solve again. Export mesh. Extract. And this looks pretty good. So I'm going to save this and overwrite low. Let's go back to Blender and let's import the model that we just exported from Instant Meshes. And call this one high. And let's go into edit mode, select all of it, and loose part or selected, P selected, select the one that we just duplicated. And call this one cage. And I'm going to hide cage. And then we'll have to UV unwrap this. So U and smart UV project. Going to go down to UV editor to see the UVs. And they look pretty good. Going to create a new image and call this T underscore rock underscore 01. And I'm going to keep this at 1024 and save this to desktop, but you can save it wherever you want. I'm going to go to shader editor, new, add image texture. And open the image that we just saved. Okay, let's unhide the cage first and let's select these both. And drag them over here. We're going to, be sure to have the image selected. And go to high, to the high poly rock model, and have that selected as well. Have the high poly model selected first, and then select the low poly model. Go over to the render tab. Go from Eevee to cycles, and go down to bake. And then on bake type, change this to diffuse. And check only color. Now we're going to go to the UV editor. And, one more thing. We need to check selected to active under the render tab. And cage, and select the cage mesh. Now we should be able to bake. And here it is. So we're going to save it and overwrite the texture on T underscore rock underscore 01. And let's hide the cage and the high poly mesh. go to Material tab and Shader Editor and connect color to base color. And there you go. We have the texture baked onto the lower poly model. Also, to bake the normals from the high poly mesh to the low poly mesh, you basically can do the same thing that you did with the diffuse texture. For example, let's make a new texture. So I'll call this one like, I don't know, rock. Normal map. And then I'm going to keep it at 1024. And check 32-bit float. And OK. Just going to open this. Okay. And then let's unhide these. And make sure the high poly mesh is selected first. And then the low poly mesh. And, oh yeah, make sure that's selected image. And then go from bake type to normal only. And that should work. But let's see UV editor. And there we go, we have our normal map. And just gonna save it. Right here. Oh yeah, let's just save it as a BMP. And non-color. Save it. And again, let's hide the cage and the high poly. And go to shader editor. And let's select the diffuse texture for this and duplicate this node and get a normal map node and connect it to the normal and to color and then change this color space to non-color. And open the normal. And change this to sRGB color space. And now as you can see, you can mess around with the normals and the normal map node. So let's compare the high poly version to the low poly version. Here's the high poly, and here's the low poly. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like. I'll be sure to leave the link to my brother's channel, Ruthless Radical, in the description. And my sister's channel, Brownie Ireland. And yeah.